are two kinds of people in this world. Those who believe in flying saucers and those who don't. I've never been one much for believing in anything I couldn't wrap my hands around and shake. But up till 2 weeks ago, I didn't know Eric Cord. Being part Indian, maybe I should have paid more attention to the ancient superstitions, demons, creatures of the night. But born and raised on West 9th Street in the Bensonhurst section of Brooklyn, the only monsters I got to know were street punks, gang members, dope pushers, loan shark enforcers. And I learned early on how to handle that kind of animal. My daddy taught me, you can stand up to anything if you got the guts to look it in the eye. If you can look it in the eye. Growing up, I remember reading the book Alice in Wonderland. After Alice went down the rabbit hole, a flower talked to her. She was surprised. You don't need to be a psychiatrist to know if a flower ever spoke to a man, that man would know terror. When the world isn't the same as our minds believe, then we are in a nightmare. And nothing is worse than a nightmare, except one you can't wake up from.
How young you are to be manager of your own company.
Well, I'm not, I mean, it's not my company, it's just I run the station.
Still, I used to date a guy who was president of Thumco Oil. Nice guy, Kim Thomerson.
Oh yeah, I know him. Well, I never met him or anything, but I heard about him.
Great guy. You'd like him. Is this yours?
Yeah.
I left my keys in the bar. I'll be right back.
Hurry.
I will.
I am. Hey. Whoa. What's wrong? Look, it was just probably some jerk who saw me go back for my keys.
Let's just get out of here.
What the hell?
No, don't open the door!
What the hell is up there?
Jail, I might as well do something.
No, why are you doing this to me?
Give me one good reason why I shouldn't.
No, because you like me, respect me, and you're my brother's best friend. Oh, and because of my dad who took you when you were 16, he's almost like your own father. And you wouldn't want to see me upset, and this is upsetting me, which would upset him. Because of this. My dad say if he knew you were kissing me like that?
Your dad's not going to be home till 6 o'clock.
What are you two doing?
Enjoying the last couple days of sun.
I'm going to tell.
You staying for dinner, Eric?
No, Ted will be back today. A couple of guys want to try and get together.
Oh, I'd like to see Ted. He used to come over weekends instead of going out of town looking for jobs. Tell him his father would like to remember what he looks like.
I'll do that.
Hi, Daddy.
Well, looks like you and me, kid. You want me to make dinner for you? One of my special tacos? Or do you have a date?
No date. I wasn't planning on leaving anyway. Ted still got my Jeep.
Good. I worry to death every night. This maniac, this animal, whatever it is. Two more kids were killed last night at some disco on Center Street.
Ted and I used to go there with Kevin and a couple of guys from his band.
Well, be careful. Whatever this nut is on, I gather he's real strong.
I think he knows.
Your dad?
No.
Come on, I'm practically family. I spend more time in this pool than you and Ted together. I spent half my life chasing you around and throwing you in.
He knows.
He does not.
He does too.
Not.
Too. Otherwise, tell him.
What's there to tell? We grew up together. There's a natural relationship that built. We're close.
We're boyfriend and girlfriend.
That too.
You're chicken.
That too.
See you later.
Nuclear. water down there.
Sorry, Mrs. Minikin, Dan. I can't get into my spot.
You'd think someone was being murdered.
Ted, get out here! Yo, Ted! Ted? Hey, Ted, are you here?
What the hell's going on? Jeez, Ted, I hope you pay the electric bill before the other things. I told you to pay that before anything. Ted? Ted, is that you?
Hey, I'm not in the mood tonight.
Heathcliff? I usually attack when I first come in. Well, what's for dinner, Heath, huh? What the hell am I still doing with the lights off? Hey, it's only a storm, sport. Something wrong with you? What's the matter, Heath? You hurt or something? Hey, come on, Heathcliff. I don't want Ted to know I love you, all right? Or he's gonna start leaving me notes to feed you and walk you and stuff like that. You're such a big baby. Dog. Jeez, Ted. Where'd you get a gun?
I bought it last month. But it takes a couple weeks to register it. I picked it up on Tuesday.
No, you were into that. Not that we couldn't use some better protection in Heathcliff. He's under the refrigerator. And you left your sister's Jeep half parked in my spot. You know, I'm out in the rain.
Leave the lights off.
Last time you sat around in the dark was when Cindy left you. You sat in the living room listening to I'm a Loser over and over.
I just want them off.
You better tell me what's going on, Ted. I mean, sitting in the dark like some lunatic with a gun, looking like you're planning to kill somebody.
I already have.
What, are you trying to tell me you had something to do with this? Come on, man. He took it off his leash or something.
Do I look like I'm joking here, Eric?
No. No, I'm just a little freaked here myself, Ted.
Come on, you're scaring the hell out of me acting this weird.
What you're trying to tell me, you had something to do with it? You're this crazy killer going around dismembering people.
It is me. Well, it's not me. But I did this.
It's fool, man. Come on, I know you. You could never kill anyone. You haven't got it in you. And Tool, let's face it, you know Mr. America, you know, I was there when Bucktooth Bernard creamed you for talking to Judy in homeroom.
I did this. Eric, I need your help. I need you badly to help me. Look, what I'm about to tell you, I haven't been able to tell anyone. And I was hoping that I wouldn't have to. That I could work it out on my own, but I can't. I can't do this on my own anymore.
I can't believe you could kill anyone, Ted. You better have one hell of an explanation to get me to believe this.
I'm a werewolf. Look, if you don't help me, it's gonna happen again tonight. It's just gotten so much worse lately. I took my cross, my mom's, you know, the one that my dad gave me when she died. And I had it melted down. Now, there's silver bullets in that gun. And you have to use it on me tonight when it happens, when I change.
Need help, Ted. Real help, man. I love you too much to even sit here and humor you like this.
Do you see that? Now it started. The cycle has begun. And it can't be stopped now. Look, I'm not crazy. Maybe I am. It is sort of a madness. It just seems to well up in me as it gets closer. That's why I know I have to stop it, end it, before it controls me more than it already does.
Ted, the help you need isn't a silver bullet. Look, I'm gonna call your dad.
My dad can't help me.
Well, let me call a doctor.
A doctor can't help me. Nothing can cure me, except dying. That's the only way. It's the only way I know. I know. Eric, no one else will believe me. I've no one else but you.
I can't help you, Ted. I don't know what I can do.
If you don't help me, I'm gonna kill someone again tonight. Who knows how many? Maybe even you. Just keep me here until midnight. Just until then. Please, just tie me up and keep me here until then. Look, if nothing else, you have me tied up. I can't go anywhere, right? And if nothing happens, you can do anything you want. You can call anyone you want.
Great, some choice. Either my friend turns out to be some science fiction monster that I have to shoot, or he's so crazy, I have to have him locked up.
Just until midnight. You can do that, please. Just until then. Last summer is when it happened. The last summer when my dad and me had that fight about me going to grad school.
when you went down to Baja to work on that fishing boat? I didn't know werewolves were seagoing animals.
The gun. Don't forget the gun. I took that job on that fishing boat with that Captain Scorzani. Anyway, I was working late that night. We just pulled in this whole load of skipjack, and I had to clean all those damn fish to get them to the market first thing in the morning. And so I cut through this old boatyard on my way home. And, you know, a couple of guys, you know, that worked on the pier, they said that this guy that owned the place, this crazy one-handed guy, Captain Hook, they used to call him, they said that he had this dog that was trained to attack you if you were shortcutting through the yard. And at first, well, that's what I thought was watching me through this big stack of old crates.
And tearing at me. And I die. Or at least, that's what I think. When I wake up the next morning, I'm covered in blood. All over. And it's mine. Only, my wounds are kind of healed. I mean, not really, but not as bad as all that blood would lead you to believe. And who's there screaming at me is this Captain Hook himself. I mean, look more dorky than scary, especially in the daylight. And there's this mean old dog. It's just some scratchy old hound dog that couldn't scare the fleas off his own back. And the more he's screaming at me, the more I'm laughing, because I'm just so damn glad to be alive. Until three nights later, and I found the sign of the pentagram on my hand. I tried to scrub it off, but it wouldn't go. And I had no idea what it was. But I could feel something happening inside me. Something weird. And that night I killed two people. But then I read in the paper that two people were killed coming out of the Bijou Theater in Valley Stream. As soon as I heard that, I knew I'd done that too.
Look, how often does this happen?
It's real random. There's no kind of schedule or cycle. But it's always preceded by the sign of the pentagram on my palm. And then I used to do what I could to keep myself locked up when I knew it was happening. Then I stopped.
Changing?
Locking myself up. I didn't want to anymore. See, even before I changed, I knew I was going to. And I wanted it.
Well, what about me, Ted? I've been asleep here nights. You've been growing fangs and hitting the streets. How come you never attacked me?
Well, even a rabid dog in the last stages of his disease can maybe discern its master and keep from attacking him. Or at least, not until real close to the end. See, I'm no longer in control. I could hurt anyone now. You, Kelly, anyone.
afraid I won't care.
So how come now, Ted? How come after all this time? What were you waiting for? If you really believe you're some sort of creature.
I thought I wouldn't have to come to this. I thought I could rid myself of the curse without having to take my life.
Oh, are there ways to lift this curse other than silver bullets and stakes in the heart?
It's only vampires, Eric.
I knew that.
Yeah. There is a way. You can end the curse by severing the original bloodline. Now, if the werewolf that attacked me was the first of the line, by killing him, I no longer go through the change.
That's where you've been every weekend for the past couple months. You haven't been looking for any summer jobs.
I'm trying to track him. It.
Well, how hard can that be? I mean, there can't be many werewolves running around the state. Look, maybe I can help.
The only way to end this is with that silver bullet.
Hey, Ted. Enough is enough. Look, I'm going to sit here with you till midnight. I'm going to do that. But you know I'm not going to shoot you.
Yes, you will.
Because you're a werewolf.
Because you love me. And because you're going to see this terrible disease that I have. And because you love me.
He made it. Made it. Listen to me.
Gun, Ted!
going on? What are you boys doing?
Cord's room.
Yes, ma'am. And how may I help you?
Well, I'd like to see him.
I don't think that's possible.
But I'm family.
Well, I don't recall hearing about any family coming to visit. He's not allowed visitors. You seem very upset here, Miss Nichols. Maybe you'd like a cup of coffee. We can talk this over. Try and work out your problem.
You seem more interested in me than solving my problem. Maybe a lieutenant would be interested in this. I'd like your badge number.
Whoa, hey, excuse me. I'm just trying to do a job.
Yeah, me. I'm sure this nurse has been a witness.
Okay.
Yeah.
I must have went out and had a bad dream. Has anyone come to visit me?
Not since your attorney lieutenant left. Are you, sure you don't want a nurse or something?
No. No, I'm okay.
This is just an arraignment. Very simple, straight ahead.
Rudy, where's your dad?
Well, he's over at the Supreme Court in front of Judge Cumberland. Don't worry about it.
Don't worry? Rudy, I could get the electric chair or something here.
No, I went over the briefs with my father last night. I know how to play this. Come on, you're undermining my confidence. If you undermine my confidence, I can't do the best of my ability. Anyway, you're going to be charged with a 402.
Well, it's murder, isn't it? I thought you were going to go for self-defense.
Well, no. First degree, second, manslaughter. Those are all murders. And you've already admitted to the shooting, so it's just a matter of us determining what the circumstances are.
Right.
You know, my dad thinks if you would have just taken that polygraph test, you could have saved us all this rigmarole.
I didn't want to.
You okay?
Those things are no good in court anyway.
Right. He just thinks it would have helped us with the DA. He might not have pushed as hard, that's all.
Give me a break here, will you? Look, I'm going through hell and a half. You know, you're supposed to be on my side.
I am on your side. I believe you. Just my dad. He wondered why you refused to take the polygraph test.
All right.
Okay.
Let's forget it. You really think they're gonna allow bail?
Oh, for sure. I mean, you have no previous offense. No previous offenses. Good student. I'm telling you, all that's gonna happen today is they're gonna charge you.
Murder?
Well, yeah. Then I'm gonna make a motion to the judge to release you on your own recognizance. And the judge will set bail at about $100,000.
$100,000?
Don't worry. I've got a bail bondsman all set up, and all you have to do is put up 10%, and boom, you're on the street.
10%? $10,000?
Yeah.
Well, I swear, I don't know how I get into these kind of squeeze boxes. I'm too good. I got too big a heart, I got. Ask anybody.
There.
And there, and there. I don't know how this thing can be worth $10,000. It's 20 years old.
That's the point. It's a classic. I could get 12 for it easy.
Hey, you don't have to sell me, kid. I give Rudy's old man my word I'd post. I'm posting you. And when Eddie Armando gives his word, you can draw interest on it. Ask anybody. I'll check the blue book, though.
I want this back. You did tell him I wanted this back, didn't you, Rudy?
Well, Eric would like his car back, Eddie,
well, yeah,
so...
I'll do my best, kid. I'm not a pawn shop, although half this town seems to think so. See that watch? I got a guy in Leavenworth told me he wanted to buy it back, too. I've been wearing it a decade. I told him I'd hold it. I held. That's the way I am.
Ask anybody. Anybody. See you later, Eddie.
Hey, you're out.
Don't worry, everything's gonna be okay. Can I give you a lift?
How'd you do it, Teddy? How'd you go through it? I feel like a giant balloon ready to burst.
I could just say it to someone who'd feel better. It rips me up to think about what happened to you, man. Without you, I don't know who I can go to. Who I can try and reason this out with.
I feel like I'm going crazy, Teddy. I'm scared, man. Let me out for the funeral. I'm sure I wouldn't have been too welcome anyway.
I'm sorry I didn't come visit you in the hospital.
I understand.
I don't understand anything anymore. Everything was so perfect for a while. It's a storybook perfect. So I don't understand at all.
Cliff.
I forgot all about you.
He was so scared when the police found him. He was hiding between the refrigerator and the counter. You know, that little space you're always dropping things.
I know he was your brother. I'd never say anything to hurt Ted.
He was sick, Kelly. He was really sick.
I know. I know all about it. About Ted being a werewolf.
I'm gonna tell Eric tonight and ask him to help me. I know that I need to end it, to die. I know that I have to, but I don't think I can do it myself. And I just pray to God that Eric has the strength. He's my last hope. I love you, Kelly. I love you and Dad, and I'm so sorry.
He must have mailed it to you the day he died, before I came home and found him. Just like he explained it to me.
Why are you doing this? Why are you saying this?
I'm sorry I don't seem to have the answers you want.
I don't need to hear some Stephen King story about monsters and curses. Not from you two.
You think I want to stand here and talk like some kind of space cadet? You think Teddy wanted to do that to me? But I don't know what else to say. There are two kind of people in this world, Kelly. Those who believe in flying saucers and those who don't. Well, I didn't. Not until this particular one jumped up and took a bite out of me.
What is happening here? What's going on?
I wish I could say something easier for you to hear. You heard Ted? You heard his voice? I think the two of us went nuts at the same time. Lunacy isn't contagious.
I don't know what to believe anymore. I don't have anything left to believe.
I just hope I have the key on me.
God, Eric, I'm sorry. This is just scaring the hell out of me.
I know, Kelly. Believe me, I understand what you're going through. But all you have to do is lock me up for the night and you take off. I just need you to do that. Look, you can do that. You have to do that for me. Come on.
My dad and I were working on this when he died. It looked complicated to me back then, and it still looks complicated.
All these things your parents?
Yep. After your father helped me straighten everything out after the funeral, there wasn't all that much money left. So I've been using what there was to pay for the storage shed. Thought if I got rid of anything, I might regret it someday.
I can't do this. I can't lock you up in here.
You have to, Kelly. You have to.
What's happening to you?
Just lock the door, Kelly. Just lock the door. Just lock the door.
Miss, you do that damage to my door? Get away from me, boy. Just stay away from me, boy. You want us something, ain't you? You better get it together and get out of here, boy. And I mean now.
Eric?
Because I'm going to call the cops on you. I'm going to have them here just faster than you.
Eric!
You better run, boy. Because I'm going to have you.
Go, Kelly, drive.
Get
go.
Your big bippy on that. I'm going to have the police after you. I got your license number. I can see your license number. Boy, I'm gonna get him.
Just like Teddy said, I couldn't stop it. I didn't know what.
What are you talking about?
I did it. I killed last night, Kelly.
No, you didn't.
It was me.
No, it couldn't have been. You didn't get out. You didn't get out last night.
but the door was busted open.
When I came back to check on you this morning, it was still latched. I opened it. You were unconscious. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know if I should try to wake you. I was afraid. Whoever or whatever killed those people in Santa Clara, it couldn't have been you.
And there's another.
What?
If it wasn't me who got loose last night, then that means there's another one out there. Maybe the one.
What are you talking about?
If it is the one who started this bloodline, the one who attacked Ted, then he can lift this curse from me.
How could I do that?
First, I have to find him. I have to kill him.
Eric, think about this.
What's there to think about?
You're under arrest. You can't just take off.
I don't have any choice, Kelly.
Let me go with you.
Don't be crazy.
Why not? Everyone else seems to be.
I was enough trouble for your father to handle. What, eloping with a werewolf? What'll our kids look like?
Eric.
Just a little dark humor to fit the mood.
My dad needed to spend some time alone. So he went up to the cabin in Arrowhead. I'll just see if Connie can watch Heathcliff till then, okay?
Let me pack some things. Then I'll swing by your place.
Okay, I'm just gonna wait here, okay? I can't go up there.
Sure.
Maybe you should call your lawyer.
And tell him what? I'm going werewolf hunting? They'll throw me in a rubber room with a box of Crayolas. I think I'm better off saying nothing.
The kid ain't around. That's the matter or the fact of it, Rudy. I spoke to the old man last night. He says you haven't been able to find him in 2 days. That means he missed his court date this morning. I don't care if you got a continuance. That's not the point. You haven't been able to reach him, so he don't know it's been pushed back. He skipped. He was supposed to be in court today. He can't be found. Now, you can't see this Eric court has split. You get yourself a shepherd and some dark glasses, huh? Okay. All right. I give you a chance. I promise. I promise I won't do nothing till I hear back from you. Stella, give me the engine.
He's not an Indian. Eddie, he's only one-third Indian on his grandmother's side.
Well, get me that third, and give me the rest of them, and give them Eric Cord's file.
You're gonna send a bounty hunter after this kid? You just said you weren't gonna do anything.
So sue me.
They send out all over the country looking for them crazies, huh? At least that's what Mr. Armandi's office told me when he called. I mean, you know, I thought that was kind of interesting. You know, an interesting way to make a living. Like Steve McQueen, you know, you go into a place and pull down a poster, and then you go out and grab the crazies, and they give you money. Real money. That's a heck of a way to make a living.
Well.
Say, mister, I was wondering, you couldn't maybe spread some of that long green around to a fellow was gonna help you, would you? No. Well, of course now.
I ain't saying that I wouldn't love to go after them guys myself anyway, after what they did to my door. I mean, somebody's gotta do something. Police ain't worth nothing, for crying out loud. They come out here. Give me hell in a handcart because I couldn't remember the whole license number. Like I'm supposed to do their job. In the movies, two numbers, and the color of the car, and bam, 20 minutes later, they're in the lockup. That's what they call it, lockup. Man, insurance company, they come out here and tell me they ain't gonna pay me. Well, I can't fix the door until they pay me, but they ain't gonna pay me until they find out what happened. Well, I'll tell you what happened. Bunch of crazies on angel's dust playing them here, flying around, DDT and all them drugs and stuff. Come in here, tore up the place, broke in, but no. The insurance company says, say, nobody broke in here, they broke out. Now that don't make a bit of sense to me. I don't care how you cut it.
Hey, what is that? What is that, mister?
Busted in, busted out, don't make no never mind to me. Any way you cut it, it's vandalism. Nothing dirtier in this world than vandalism. I hate vandalism.
Was working on a fishing boat when he was attacked.
God, Eric. I mean, the past 2 days have been pretty good. But you're scaring me again.
I can't explain it to you, Kelly. I can just tell. Can you go back to the motel?
Come with me. Eric!
Looking for work, and I thought
you should think about not boarding no man's ship unless you've been given the okay to do it.
Sir.
So wait a minute. All right, come with me.
Scrizzini, aren't you?
I am.
I'm Eric Cord.
sit down. So, why did you come here, boy?
I told you. I was looking for a job, and I thought...
Why'd you come, boy? You're one of mine, aren't you? Yes. You met one of mine, didn't you? I can tell.
Then you know what's happened to me.
You found me, didn't you? You think I didn't sense you long before you sensed me? Do you think your instincts are any match for mine? Do you, boy?
My friend is dead. And I killed him.
Well, did you now? Did you save your friend from his horrible existence, son? But not before he brought you into the club, huh?
I don't want to be like this.
Well, then kill yourself. That's the way a werewolf dies. By his own hand, or by a silver bullet, or by another werewolf. Did you come to kill me? Is that what you did, huh? But not tonight. Not tonight, you don't. Because tonight, we hunt.
No, no.
Oh, yes, it's already begun. But don't you know? Because there's no sign you think not, huh? It'll come, you'll see. I don't need to wait for the sign. I already know the cycle has begun. I can feel it in me, strong. And tonight, we feast, both of us, on all the unsuspecting, together.
What do you think you can do if he's as powerful as you say?
I don't know, Kelly. We'll have to worry about that tomorrow. Right now, you have to tie me up and lock me in the bathroom. This rope should be strong enough. Do it, Kelly. As soon as I'm tied up, you get out of here. You place an anonymous tip to the local police and tell them that Squarzini's the killer in the paper. Maybe they'll check it out and find him, see something, catch him. I don't know. Kelly, wait, I forgot to take my clothes off. I can see this turn of events is going to play hell in my wardrobe budget.
You still have a sense of humor. That's good, boy.
Kelly!
She's fine, boy. She says goodbye. She's about to be eaten by the big bad wolf. Just like in that fairy tale. I have a sense of humor too, boy. Don't I?
Help! Someone there, help me! Thank God. Look, you have to help me. Someone broke in and robbed me.
Whatever you're in, son, I don't need to know.
Hey, what are you doing? Who are you?
Name's Rogan. You see, I'm your magic carpet back to a little holding cell. They got all clean and waiting for you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you don't. You're not Eric Cord, neither. You ain't charged with the murder of your roommate. And you're not stupid enough to skip town and
miss your trial date.
Makes no never mind to me.
Okay, man, I'll go with you. I don't care. But the girl I was with, Kelly Nichols, she's been kidnapped.
Damn it, she was. This crazy bastard, Giannis Scorzini. He's gonna kill her.
You have to believe me.
All I have to do, son's what I'm doing now. Enjoy the ride.
Listen to me, will you,
don't
for a minute?
Don't touch me. What the hell's that? You bleeding, kid?
Just go. Go on, get out of here. Lock me in.
Are you hurt?
Just go after Kelly, please. Just go after her.
What you got in there?
I don't know.
Thank you.
Kel?
I love you, Eric. I really do. I
can't. Don't say anything.
How can you live like this?
It's kind of like as horrible as cancer or something like that is. When you get it, you get it. But inside, you know it. Still walking around, still living, existing. I just can't give up.
What are you gonna do?
Find Scorzini.
Look. You saw what happened. You saw what he became.
I don't know what I saw, Kelly. I just remember him taking you. I had to get to you. To help you. That thought never left me.
Well, maybe he's not such a part of you anymore. Maybe it's ending.
No. It's just beginning. And I don't know how long I'll be able to remember things after I change.
Get some help or something.
I need to find Scorsese. That's my help. That's what I have to do. He's out there. I'm going after him.
I'm gonna be in the whole 90 grand. 90 G's, and I got a missing bounty hunter.
Well, when Rogan called yesterday, he said he had a pretty good line on Cord.
Yeah, he's got a pretty good line, and me, I got a 20-year-old drop-top Mustang, which is now officially on the market. I can't believe this. Did you try the engine at home?
I tried him at home.
Try again.
I just did.
Humor me for 90 grand. I should be able to be humored. I don't believe this. Now I gotta hire a bounty hunter to locate my bounty hunter.
There are two kinds of people in this world. Those who believe in flying saucers and those who don't. The world is isn't the same as our minds believe, then we are in a nightmare. And nothing is worse than a nightmare. Except one you can't wake up from.